I was working on a 12-12 shift from Stacksted Station when I was called to a Category 1 emergency. Very shortly after introducing myself, this male jumped up and started to attack me by means of throwing punches. As I tried to retreat back from the scene, I then ended up falling into the road with this male. As I fell into the road, we ended up rolling around on the floor. Unfortunately, an off-duty police officer at the time was just driving to his shift, starting his shift in Greater Manchester. He came to my assistance. I pressed my panic button on my radio. That alerted to my control that I was being attacked.
I shot around the corner there to go and assist Andrew. At that time, Andrew was sort of stood next to the patient. Andrew was covered in blood. Spoke to Andrew. Andrew was okay at this point, although obviously visibly shaken. I then went to assist the patient to find out what was going on. And it's at this point that he attacked myself.
Throughout the incident, we continued to treat this male, managed to get him onto a stretcher, take him into the back of the ambulance, identify his injuries and manage those. Only after the incident was over did we realise actually that I'd sustained injuries, and also John had broken his hand, which required us both to have hospital treatment.
And as you can see, this might have resulted in a fractured hand.
My focused attention was on treatment of patients, and so it was only after we'd sort of secured him onto the stretcher, managed all his wounds, put bandages on his hands, that we actually realised that John had hurt his hand, and indeed I'd hurt my neck and wasn't able to feel my arms properly. At that point we both realised that we should probably be seen at hospital ourselves.
I'm going to be off work for approximately 8 weeks. Definitely affects Christmas celebrations. I was down to do a couple of overtime shifts, so I can't drive for the next 8 weeks.
The right for someone to turn around and attack both of us and cause injuries to myself and my colleague John, they have no right to do that at all, and it's not acceptable.
I've been on this service now for 14 years. Over the 14 years I've been subject to a lot of verbal aggression, and this happens to many paramedics and technicians there out on the road. It's not acceptable. We need to put a stop to this.
The health and well-being is at the forefront of what the impact is. The next impact is, because Andrew and John are now off the main operational duties, we've got to be able to cover the duties that they had, especially over our busy period of Christmas and New Year. We are seeing a rise in assaults on our staff. There's been 68 reported assaults on our staff in Lancashire alone year to date in 2017. We're working closely now, liaising with Lancashire Constabulary, and there will be hopefully will be leading to a prosecution. But we've also had from the Chief Executive concerns, and he sent his thoughts to both Andrew and John and supported them in the investigation. And also Peter Mulcahy, our Head of Service, has expressed his concerns about violence against our staff in Lancashire.